Hi all! This is the second part for the new features seen in Vray 6. If you haven't checked the first part, I have a link in this video description and you can also click on the top right corner. So, in the first video, we explored the chaos scatter, the procedural clouds and the Vrayan mess, and in this video we will see the finite dome and improvements on the Vray material like the thin film option, the uniform mode in the translucency, and the improved energy preservation. I will start with the finite dome. I have this car and I want to render it in an environment. Instead of modeling the environment, I can use an Hdri. In general, when I use Hdris in my projects to light a scene, I use the ones in the Chaos Cosmos browser. But for our example now, since I need an Hdri that shows some landscape, I will go to Polyheaven, to the HDRIs, and for my example, I will use this one. I will go back to 3ds Max and create a Vray Dome light by clicking on its icon on the Vray toolbar. I will click on the top viewport to place it, and then go to the Modify tab. Click on Nomap button and choose Vray Bitmap. Then load the HDRI I downloaded. I will start the interactive rendering. If I turn around my viewport, you can see that the car is basically floating. An easy way to fix this is to go to the HDRI setting and enable the ground projection. Now, this is better, but our problems are still not solved. If I try to zoom in or zoom out, the car gets affected, but not the HDRI. And if I try to move the HDRI using the Select and Move command, nothing changes. Let me disable the ground projection, and now we will explore a new method. So, what's new in Vray 6 regarding the Vray Dome light? In the Dome Light rollout, we have this new option called Finite Dome. When we enable it, the preview changes drastically. What does the Finite Dome do? It allows us to fine-tune our ground projection. Our dome now is not infinite as before, but it has a size. By enabling the Finite Dome, some extra settings get enabled. The radius, the projection height, and the ground blend. The radius controls the radius of the dome, so let me increase it. We see some distortion here, but we can adjust it through the projection height. In the projection height, we have to set the height from which the HDRI was captured. Of course, we know this only we have taken the photo, so in our case, since we don't know it, we will eyeball it until it looks correct. So now I think it's looking good. As you can see in the new Finite Dome option, the environment is reacting to my movement. When I now use the Select and Move command, by changing the position of the dome light, the HDRI is also moving and I can also zoom in or zoom out. Finally, the ground blend controls the transition between the ground plane and the upper part of the dome. A value of 0 means a sharp transition, while a value of 1 means that the dome morphs into a sphere. The default value of 0.2 I believe works great. Now, depending on the HDRI you will choose to use, there are some that helps us understand their scale. So, in this HDRI, I see this crossing. So, let me Google car on zebra crossing. And don't get confused by the sketches, we are interested in the actual photos. And as you can see, a car usually equals approximately 2 to 3 lines. So I will go back to my project. And I need to adjust the radius of my dome and the projection height. I think now it's more realistic scale-wise. When we are close to the edges of the dome, you can see that the objects look like they are bending. So try to move the dome and to adjust your angle to avoid having them being visible. Finally, to make the car look realistic in this environment, we need to add a shadow catcher. I will create a Vray plane. And then simply click on this button, Make Vray Shadow Catcher through the Vray Object Properties. That's perfect now. So the finite dome is really useful when the dome serves both as a background and to project the light texture on the ground. Next new feature we will see is the thin film. The thin film is a new rollout in the Vray material, and as its name states, it recreates the effect of a thin film on a surface, giving the material an iridescent look. It can mostly be used for bubbles and car paint. Let me create a sphere to imitate a bubble. I will open the material editor, create a Vray material, and apply it to the bubble. I will set the diffuse color to black, the reflection color to light gray, and the refraction color to light gray as well. So now I have created a glass sphere. In the refraction section, we have the thin walled option, and if we enable it, we create a bubble. This option is used for transparent materials like the bubble we are working on, or curtains, or leaves, and so on. Now, a soap bubble has an iridescent look. To achieve this, we will use the thin film rollout. I will enable the thin film, and you can immediately see that some iridescent color is added. If I change the minimum and the maximum thickness, the color variation changes. If we also change the reflective index of the thin film, we get different looks. We can also add a grayscale map. The black color will correspond to the minimum thickness and the white color to the maximum thickness. This way, we are able to give variation to the color effect and replicate things like the swirly noise pattern on a soap bubble. Let me add a noise map to check this out. Now, I know that most of you are wondering how often will you need to make soap bubbles, but as I said earlier, we use the thin film when we want to give an iridescent look to any object. Another new option in the Vray material in Vray 6 is the uniform mode in the translucency. I have created a detailed video on the translucent materials and you can find the link in this video description and at the top right corner. So please check it if you don't know what they are and how to create them. So as I explained there, in Vray 6 we have a new option, the uniform mode, which renders faster than the directional we had before. Additionally, we are now allowed to add a map on the SSS color and SSS amount. This helps us give more variation to the final result. Finally, an improvement in Vray 6 is that it renders more physically accurate rough metals and in general reflective surfaces with the improved Vray material energy preservation. Regarding this improvement, you don't really have to do anything. It's automatically applied on any new material you will create. Do not get confused with the preserve energy option you see in the options rollout. As I said, you don't have to act on this new improvement. What does energy conservation mean? Vray tries to keep the total amount of light reflected off a surface to be less than or equal to the light falling on the surface. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. I will see you all in my next video.